Oh man, the 4K 60 frames update for the next gen is here. Let's compare the two, shall we? Are you ready? Let's go! What up YouTube? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for clicking my content, really appreciate you joining me. If you like my content and want to help the channel out, don't forget to smash that like button. And yesterday was the day that we received the 4K 60 frames update. And like I mentioned in several videos before, that it would be a big change. But man, this is just incredible. I never thought that the 60 frames would make this big of a difference. I recorded a few clips to try to compare the 30 versus 60 frames. Last week I recorded some clips on the PS5. Today and yesterday I recorded some clips with the TU12.1 update live and the 4K 60 frames. These recordings are both recorded on 1080p with the Elgato HD60S. I didn't change any settings in-game or within my device. But it may seem so, and maybe after the update some in-game settings have changed, but I couldn't find any. I got too much hours in the game, so believe me when I say this, going from 30 to 60 frames is big. Anyway, I'm gonna show you two clips comparing the 30 versus 60 frames. We'll both slow them down by 50% to really see the difference. Let's start with the leak run on Federal Emergency Bunker. Walking into the room, you instantly notice the 30 frames is a bit brighter, but the 60 frames show so much more detail. Let's focus on the first fight. The difference between 30 and 60 is big, especially when we slow it down. The 60 frames run so much smoother and not as choppy as the 30 frames. Almost seeing every detail while shooting on the 60 frame side of it. I will keep this clip running, but it's so hard to mimic the gameplay from before. But still, you see a big difference between the two. Although the gameplay isn't exactly the same, the 60 FPS shows so much more detail. For my second clip, I can show you the difference a bit better, as the route is easier to mimic. And again, you instantly see the difference in how the character moves and all the details around him. The tree in front of us shows so much more detail. And even if we turn the corner, you can see a lot more in the background, as we can clearly see the bush behind the fence on the 60 frames, but need some time to show up on the 30 frames. When running straight ahead, you again see so much color and detail between the two. And then let's focus on the jump. This time how much smoother it is. Slowing it down again and you can really see the difference. And this is how it should be, right? 60 frames makes a big difference. And as far as I know, this update is only for the next gen console and won't allow you to have 1080p 60 frames on PS4 or Xbox One. So if you're blessed with the next gen console, you're definitely going to enjoy the game a lot more. I cannot confirm if the game runs on 1080p with 120 frames on the PS5. But with my new BenQ monitor on the way, we might pull it off. Keep an eye on the channel as more content is uploaded daily. But for today, thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course the notification bell. Pure Prime out.